Hello, Internet, and welcome to Episode 3 of Philosophy 50. Today we're focusing on Occam's Razor, a philosophy that entails always choosing the simplest option, the one with the least unsupported assumptions, when you need to make a decision. Now, real quick before we get into that, as you can see, we have some more Mark of the Ninja. Unlike my other video, this is not a stealth run. This is a terror run where I kill as many people as possible and get myself into lots of trouble with the guards so that I can gut them gruesomely later. As you can see right now, bats prey. So anyway, that's what's going on screen. Other than that, this is episode 3. I'm still doing it 5 months later. But I'm not going to make any promises because that equals disappointment for me and anyone who likes me, which is just me. So anyway, back to Occam's Razor. Occam's Razor essentially dictates that if you have choices in a situation, you choose the one that requires you to make the least leaps of faith. So the example that I have is crop circles. If you all of a sudden discover crop circles, there are two potentials that are usually popped up in the mainstream media, and one is aliens, and two is not aliens. So Occam's Razor says you pick two, not aliens. Why? Because you have to assume that aliens are visiting Earth. That is a bigger assumption than people go into cornfields and cause trouble, which people have been doing for centuries. So Occam's Razor says pick the one with the least unsupported assumptions. That would be option one, aliens. Picture me as the guy with his hands up and the crazy hair. And turns out that in this particular case, it's right. The people that did that admitted to it shortly afterwards. Occam's Razor doesn't always work in that way, but it's a good starting point for investigations and for any sort of trying to solve a problem. It helps out with keeping your options open because it is provisional. You're not ruling out the other options, you're just saying they're less likely to exist. So it helps with that because it's not exclusive, and it helps you save time because generally, you know, unlike crime shows, there's usually not that big of a plot twist, unfortunately. Our romantic imaginations would like to think so, but most times life is unfortunately simple. And that's another thing that Occam's Razor values, obviously, but this is my own extrapolation, is simplicity. So, moving away, now that we know what it is, I want to get into things that I take from this, because this is all about me, right? This is narcissism at its finest. One sec, though, I have to drink. Like a fish. Pacific blue marlin, to be exact. So what do I take away from this and find helpful? And hopefully someone else finds helpful, too. I want to focus on three things in particular that I find most interesting and applicable about the theories. And honestly, I could just be pulling things out of the wording, but it doesn't really matter because they're good ideas either way. So, three things. The first is assume little. That's a basic principle of the razor, but it's something that's very useful to keep in mind. The second is be open-minded. Obviously, even though aliens probably didn't create crop circles, there is the possibility that they did. And when you maintain a philosophy and a frame of mind that doesn't rule that out, it becomes kind of the Sherlock Holmes, not syndrome, but whatever, the Sherlock Holmes complex, where he says, when all possibilities are ruled out, go to impossibilities. That's not verbatim, obviously. I'm not British, but but that's the idea. And even though, again, that's not something that you might apply every day, it is still useful, and it helps when you need creative solutions, and that's something that is highly valued in our modern, competitive, aggressive world. And then the third thing, and I think probably most important, is to value simplicity. Live minimally, value simplicity, etc. So, going back to maintaining as few assumptions as possible and being investigative, I think this is incredibly important in a time where there are so many possibilities and contingencies for any particular situation that if you don't really know something, then you don't really know it, because there are so many other possibilities of existence in our globally connected world. It's important to know what you know and know that you know it, and the best way and only way to do that is if you find it out for yourself. Assuming little and knowing much is one thing that is, I think, quite useful, quite interesting as an idea. Options, you open, I mean, being open-minded, that's pretty simple. You always want to do that because it helps you out. People that are intolerant are really just closing off potential solutions to problems. Now, there are degrees of separation that I think should exist amongst people. Like, if you don't like now, I want to be clear here. When I say culture, I don't mean ethnic culture. I mean, if you are someone who doesn't value things like strip clubs and bars, which I know I'm picking on a large portion of the populace, but whatever, fuck you. If you're not someone that values that, and you find someone that does value that, that's their culture, okay? That's their individual culture, and hence you don't value their individual culture. So if you want degrees of separation between those kinds of cultures, that's fine. But in general, you should be as open-minded as possible because you have new solutions, new knowledge, you gain better understanding of yourself and others, blah, blah, blah. These are things you already know. They were drilled into my head since I was a wee lad in elementary school, which, by the way, is the worst fucking experience of my life. Being in public schooling was such a nightmare. I'm so glad I just graduated. I graduated a year early. I skipped a year of high school, and I recommend it to anyone. It's not that hard. It doesn't involve good grades, and it just involves doing lots of community service, and it's a great idea. But that, totally unrelated. So, the third and most important, valuing simplicity. There's been a lot of movement recently towards minimalism in our culture, that I see, at least, that you see minimalist wallpapers, minimalist furniture, all sorts of stuff, minimalist paintings, and I think that this is bringing back something very ancient. Of course, it originated in China, at least from what I've seen, which is the idea that you should, and Greece also, but you should limit your worldly possessions. That's something that's hard to do, at least in our modern world, if you want to engage. But because you are at least adopting a mindset of limiting your material worth, you start to focus more on your intellectual, spiritual, human, cultural, intangible, all these higher values. You start to focus on the worth of those things about yourself. And honestly, I think that's much more important than, you know, do I have the nicest clothes? Do they fit you? Great. That's it. That's what you need. Do they fit you, and do you like them? You don't need to have a lot. You don't need to have the most expensive. That's a cliche example, but whatever. Fight me. So, valuing simplicity, being minimalist, I think is a very underrated trait in our society, and something that when applied, creates a lot of room for mental opportunity and internal growth in a way that just isn't possible when you're focused on tangible items, which is unfortunate because in America we have a consumer culture that rams its dick down your throat all the time, and that's what we value. I mean, it's evident on all the commercials we have, but that's irrelevant. So, Occam's Razor, in summary, assume little, have an open mind, and value simplicity. These are things that I found helpful. I hope you do too, and I hope that you enjoyed this video as well. So, thanks for tuning in, and I will see you. I'm going to steal this in the next chapter. Goodbye.